head down.
Okay.
Focus on the ball.
Okay.
Don't look up. Just stay right on.
I got it.
Follow through.
Yep. Yep. So just bring it back, huh?
Yep.
Okay.
Wow.
Not bad, huh?
That's pretty good.
Not bad.
That was great.
I'm getting there.
Wow.
You know, this is a really nice course.
It's a beautiful course. Look at this.
Really
beautiful
is.
Southern California.
It's really awesome.
It's a gorgeous
course.
Who
referred you to this?
Well, a good friend of mine named Tom referred me to this golf course.
Is that
Thank
right?
you, Tom.
Yeah, that was awesome. That was awesome. And you know, referrals are really important. How about when you were working for Valley Crest? How many of your jobs would come to you on referrals?
Well, when we're really on our game,
yeah,
almost 60 to 70%
were
referred
good.
To us, which is really a really not a cold lead. That's not a cool lead. That's not a warm lead. That's a hot lead.
Yeah.
And we love hot leads. And most of those are referrals.
That's awesome. Yeah. I think in residential, it might be as high as 80% and sometimes 100%. I don't know if I like 100%, but 80% is a pretty good goal in residential work, okay? But commercial, you're saying about 50?
Yeah, if you're at 50, you're doing pretty good. You know,
yep.
Today's reality is probably, depending how you nurture your customers, it could be as low as 30 and as high as 50, 60%. So
yep.
If you're on that 50-ish, you're looking pretty good for referrals.
Yeah, and that's probably happening to you too. If you do quality work, that's what happens. But let me ask you something. When you get a referral from someone, what do you do for that person? Because it's really important, because you want to continue getting those referrals in, okay? So you need to have a referral reward program. Isn't that true?
What's that? Yeah. So what would that look like?
Well, here's the way I look at it. I have a three-tiered system, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So the first would be, if somebody refers you to a job, you go, but you don't get the job, I think it's really important to send at least a handwritten note back.
Even if you didn't get the job?
Even if you didn't get the job.
Oh, okay.
Send a thank you back to the person who referred you.
That's a good idea.
That's so important because they'll do it again, okay? And tell them you didn't get the job, but it's the thought that counts coming from them and how much you value that. It could be three sentences, but get, you know, company stationery, the personalized stationery, not the large 11x8.5, okay? Get the create, or have that printed up. The second is, if you get the job, do something for the person. You know, $2,000 to maybe a $5,000 job, something in that neighborhood. Well, I like the, you know, the fruit baskets the edible arrangements they have now, or maybe a Godiva chocolate basket, you know, for a woman. Something like that.
Good.
So it just shows it. And I like to send it on a Friday afternoon, you see, so they have the whole weekend to enjoy it.
Good
and
idea.
When folks come over the house and say, wow, look at this. Or if it's in an office, you're going to send it to an office where there's a group there, send it Monday morning so they have the whole week to enjoy it. The third would be, it's a big job. Okay, I'm talking maybe $10,000, $20,000 and up. That type of a job, I would most likely send them a gift certificate to a real high-end restaurant, okay? And it, the price is up to you. I'd start at $100, huh? That's pretty good.
Oh, easy, yeah.
Yeah, easy $100 or more, okay, for that. And they'll love you for it, because if you're giving that to a woman, what's the husband gonna think, or the boyfriend gonna think when they're out to dinner? Hey, keep those referrals coming so we get more dinners, right?
Yeah,
see?
Heck yeah.
And so they're gonna think of you every single time, okay? So it's important to follow that step. And if you have account managers working for you, or salespeople, and they're referring, make sure you give them the ability to send those gifts out, you know, without asking permission. It's part of the deal. And send it out right away. That's key, okay?
Yeah, now for some of you guys on the commercial side of it, and if you're doing public works, and even on some of the private work section, you gotta be careful and know the bylaws of the organization. So it doesn't look like you're just greasing the skids here a little bit, if you know what I mean. So be careful there and know their bylaws and their culture. So make sure you check up on that.
Yeah, that's a really good point. That's a really good point. So we hope you enjoyed this information. It really does work, and we've documented just tons and tons of information on our Harvest Academy. Just click below and you'll see it there. And if you'd like more information on referrals, just click on the referral information. We have a link down below. You'll see it. And there's a download from my book, Green Side Up, that goes into that a little bit further. I think you'll really enjoy it. It's a quick read, too. Probably take you 5 minutes at the most. So we've enjoyed having you with us this Friday morning, and I only hope that you can take advantage of the offers we're giving. This is Head Harvester Ed LaFlamme from the East Coast.
Head Harvester Bill Armand. And look, I'm going to refer myself right down here to this ball. I'm going to make this ball come a lot
show
closer
me how to do
the
it,
pin
though.
That
come on,
my buddy Harvester Ed
all right,
did.
Okay, all right.
Just a nice little... Yep. Oh! It's just like that, our Mr. Ed.
Pretty good, Bill.
That's what I'm talking about. Two-foot gimme.
I can
do that. Is that a gimme putt?
Yeah, that is.
You bet it is. I'll go pick it. Why don't you go pick it up for me?
Wait, which one?
Get them all. I don't care.
There's too many there.